going on YouTube? I'm Tap. I play games. In today's video, we are playing SmackDown Here Comes the Pain. We are starting a season mode playthrough. Now, if you are familiar with SmackDown Here Comes the Pain, you see this Rob Van Dam attire and you're saying to yourself, this does not look like anything he has in the game. Well, this is the SmackDown Here Comes the Pain Definitive Edition mod. I will put a link in the description to the two videos I used to download the PlayStation 2 emulator. And then I'll put a link in the description to Scott J, his YouTube channel, on his Patreon. He's the creator of this mod. If you sign up for his Patreon, $5 a month, or you can pay, I think, like $60 annually or something like that. But $5 a month is all you need, and you can download this mod. It's amazing. You got a bunch of different attires, different theme music. It's not fully done yet. Like, he has a Jeff Hardy from Shut Your Mouth in here, but he's trying to get the early build of Here Comes the Pain so he could put the actual Jeff Hardy into this mod. It's not done yet, but it is amazing. You have Jeff Hardy, Al Snow, Bradshaw, Raven, like a bunch of wrestlers that are from other games, from other time periods, that didn't make it into the final cut. He's made it his mission to go back into like the early builds and find wrestlers that got cut and put them in the game. Hulk Hogan's in this. It's crazy. It's an amazing mod, and we're about to start a season mode playthrough. So if you guys could, please slap like on the video. Please subscribe if you're new here. I have no views, no subscribers, no nothing. This is a new channel. I have one video on the channel right now. It's a Medal of Honor video. So go check that one out too. But without further ado, it's time to start this SmackDown Here Comes the Pain Definitive Edition season mode playthrough. That's a mouthful. Let's get into it. All right, so here we go. New season. Do not want to carry over existing data. Default it. Yes, we'll use stables. Why not? Continue, continue, continue. All right, so here is the full roster of this game. Now, keep in mind, a lot of the main wrestlers, like The Rock, Stone Cold, Rob Van Dam, like a lot of these guys have 3, 4, 5 attires, like a bunch of attires added from this mod. But additionally, here's all the wrestlers that they added with the mod. So Scotty Too Hotty, Spike Dudley, Taz, William Regal, X-Pac, Al Snow, Billy Gunn, Billy Kidman, Bradshaw, Chuck Palumbo, DDP, Farouk, Hardcore Holly, Hulk Hogan, Jeff Hardy, Mark Henry, and that's the start. So those are all the added wrestlers. We're probably going to pick Jeff Hardy. We'll go season mode with Jeff Hardy, which it might be a little rough to start. But I want to build Jeff Hardy up to be a beast. So we're going to go Jeff Hardy, season mode. Let's start. There's one question people always ask me. Why do you wrestle? I ask myself the same question every morning, feeling the pain. But I do it for so many reasons. The rush of adrenaline, the roar of the crowd, the glory of the championship. But I know there is more to it. Maybe I'm doing this to find an answer. Maybe when I get to the top of the squared circle, I'll find out something about myself. Maybe I won't find out anything. But I guess I'll step into that ring again tonight because I know the view from there is unbelievable. So that's the beginning of SmackDown Here Comes the Pain. I probably read that about 20 to 30 times in my life, to be honest with you. I've beaten this game so many times. But I've never beaten it in a modded form with a bunch of new wrestlers. That's why I'm so excited to play this mod. WrestleMania was a huge success. The dust is not settled yet. The main event was awesome. I think the fans had trouble sleeping last night. We should apologize ahead of time. You might have trouble sleeping tonight as well. There he is, Eric Bischoff. Hey, Jeff. As you probably know, I'm the GM of Raw. As the GM, I have certain duty to provide the best quality show to the fans, but you're a smart guy, so I don't have to explain this to you. Don't let the pressure get to you, and welcome to Monday Night Raw. Time to see who we're fighting first. Go to match. And we're wrestling Billy Gunn first. Okay, so let's skip Sean O'Hare versus Lance Storm. And here we go. About to fight Billy Gunn. And yep, okay. I'm gonna make sure it wasn't no DQ. Cause you know damn well I'd be going for a chair straight away. So some of the creator wrestlers don't have Titantrons. I'm assuming that once this build is more fleshed out, this is version 10.5, version 11, I think it's coming, excuse me. Version 11 is coming out pretty soon. Once it does, I don't know if that's gonna add Titantrons or what, but either way you have at least the music and you have the wrestlers. So that's, I mean, to me, the fact that these wrestlers didn't exist, and now they do, is good enough for me. But of course, we're going to want Titantron, so I'm sure they'll be here. Comes Jeff Hardy. So this is my favorite model of Jeff Hardy from Shut Your Mouth. The music is included with the mod, obviously. There is no design for Jeff Hardy, and there is no Titantron. So I use just Travis Titantron just because it's purple. It kind of, if you don't look at it, but you see it in the corner of your eye, you're just like, oh yeah, it's Jeff Hardy. And then I'm using Lita's entrance, which is kind of weird, but it kind of looks like Jeff Hardy's entrance. It's more so than Matt's one, I think, actually. So that's why I'm going with Lita's entrance. The creator of the mod is trying to get an early build of Here Comes the Pain that has Jeff Hardy in it before he was taken out of the game. And he's going to try to put that version of Jeff Hardy in, which if you haven't seen that version of Jeff Hardy, I'll show a picture on the screen. It's amazing. So here we go. Obviously, he has Jeff Hardy's moveset because Jeff Hardy's still in the game. The moveset, at least. So that's not a problem. Just a matter of... building up the stats now that we're using the season stats, because it seems like... I mean, I've done multiple moves on Billy Gunn. Look how small the ring out meter... Or not ring out meter, the meter is for me. And look at Billy Gunn. He's really done any moves on me. His is a lot bigger, so it's going to be a while before I can... do a finisher at this rate. So there's gonna be some like lag here and there with the game. I'm gonna have to mess with the emulator settings. Ooh, he just reversed me. I'm gonna have to mess with the emulator settings a bit to see if I can stop it from this like this lagginess it has, but I think to a certain extent, like, you just kind of can't help it. Another whisper in the wind. Let's go. That's one thing that sucks about doing season mode stats. Your character is super underpowered and he's super weak, so like I'm taking a lot of damage. Even though I've pretty much been destroying Billy Gunn this whole time. But look at that. Super weak. Billy Gunn already has his finisher. Now I'm gonna have to play cheap here. Just so I don't get destroyed. Keep taunting. The problem is I don't even know if I'll be able to put him away even if I hit a finisher on him. That's the part that sucks. I might be pretty weak for a while. Let's go. Oh, how did I miss that? Okay, but I hit this one time. That's weird. Honestly, I might move the SmackDown meter to faster. That way I can at least get my finisher faster, because this is going to be like, this is going to suck. But as long as you stay outside, you can't pin me, so that's positive. Come on, one, two. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Nope. Gotta hear that. Come on, one, two. Oop. Run away. Okay, well, I actually did not see this coming. This sucks. Well, this will be an easy move right here, because he'll be looking outside the ring. Come on, give me an orange body. Ah, really? Get out of here with that. Oh, he might pin me here. Get out of here. Oh, let's go. I successfully reversed all his finishers. Okay. It's my time to shine here. Go. That's not gonna get him, obviously, but. No. Knock me out of the ring. That might be it. That sucks. Wow. A big L by your boy to start. That is no bueno. Okay, we're going to have to change something up here because that was awful. Ugh. I've seen enough of that. Okay, so I'm going to have to change something up because that actually sucked. That was terrible. Skip Rockin' Austin. Okay, do I get... I got 3 experience points from that. Okay, let's actually go back. Go back. Let's put... Let's go SmackDown Icon Charge Speed on Fastest. Now, that's really going to help my opponents, but it should help me as well, which I need all the help I can get right now because I did not realize Jeff Hardy was going to be like spitting spit wads at the opponent the whole time. That was awful. Okay. Let's continue. It sucks we lost our first match, but I'll make a recovery. I promise. Well, limo just pulled up, folks. I wonder who's inside. Must be those centerfold models coming to pick me up. Yeah, right. Alright, let's see if I can make my attributes go up at all. Yeah, I don't have enough for anything to go up. Okay. Well, I would have maybe had enough if I would have won that last match, but... Ah, the worst. This is the worst. When you lose your first match and SmackDown Here Comes the Pain, you take a bunch of L's. They do not even book you. Comes Vince McMahon. How are you all doing tonight? Good, I hope. Actually, you should all be grateful. Grateful you have something to do tonight in this piece of crap town. Anyway, let's cut to the chase. Jeff Hardy, you're a great talent, no doubt. You're not like these other low-life scum in this town. You actually have a further, you actually have a future in life. But don't get too cocky that I'm out here praising you. Remember, all WWE superstars on my property. I can make you and I can break you. Whether you'll be in the WrestleMania main event next year or not is all up to me. So don't you forget that. That is all. Well, Vince McMahon already being a jerk. I may have to request a title shot. Because I might be, like, locked out of Raw now because I lost my first match. Which sucks if that's the case. Let me go see if I can talk to Eric Bischoff and see what the deal is. What do you want? Request a title shot. These are the titles you can challenge for. World Tag Team Intercontinental Hardcore. Let's do that. I'm gonna randomly pick. Eyes closed and stop. Do not compete. Well, that's not an option. Do not compete. Not an option. Intercontinental. Let's go for the Intercontinental title. Well, we're challenging for Intercontinental title tonight, so that's good. I don't know if I'm prepared for it, actually, thinking about it, but this can be DQ off, though, so that'll help. So, uneventful first week, skip the second week, third week, didn't really earn it, but we got a title shot. Oh, Christian starts out with 2 finishers? Are you serious? 2 finishers right away would put me out. We're grabbing it. Oh, no. I'm supposed to grab a chair. Pin him. Do a grapple move here, see if we get... I feel like the charge speed doesn't look like it got any faster because of how slow it was before anyways. Go grab a chair. Run away. Woo! There we go. Beautiful. Okay. I feel like chair shots still don't do much. like damage wise, like I'm getting better superstar smackdown meter, I mean, but I feel like most times you hit someone four times with a chair and their head's hurting. Not the case for me. Your chair finisher. Okay. Dude, this guy is not, Christian's not even hurt. This is going to be rough. I think actually challenging for Intercontinental title is the worst thing I could have done, because now I'm going to be having title matches every week, and I don't know if I'll even be able to defend myself. This was a bad decision all around, I think. But you know what? We're going for it. No, dude, I'm going to be all red after this. Bro, my face is already orange. Are you kidding me? My head's already orange. How is Christian not even like a little bit hurt right now? This is insanity. There we go. About time. No, leave me alone, leave me alone, leave me alone. Whew, I got lucky there. Run away. Let's see if we can get her to grab a table. No, finisher. Dream twist of fate. Kind of on the chair, but not really. Alright, we just gotta hit this guy at the chair the whole time. Honestly, what I should have done was hardcore title, because then I could have been doing hardcore matches every week, but I guess if it's a title match, it's no DQ anyways. So that kind of works out. Christian's finally hurting though, so that's good. Good long enough. Chair finisher. Ooh, I was hoping to make his head red. That was stupid. Can go for it here. Oh, no. Let's go, chair finisher. Yes. Is there a rope break? Who cares? One, two, three. You're new Intercontinental Champion now. I know I didn't deserve it. I mean, I had the superstar points, so technically I deserved it. But did I really deserve it, though? I don't know. Regardless, we probably should get a good amount of experience for winning a championship. Even if it's just the Intercontinental. Oh, damn. Christian's throwing a fit. Championship looks nice on Jeff Hardy, I will say that. A little bit of a glitch it looks like though, but looks nice though, regardless. So, the question is, are we going to be not getting booked every week, even though we're champion, Intercontinental Champion? I hope not. But skip that, skip that. 18 experience, okay. I forget what your superstar points have to be in order to challenge for the WWE Championship. It might be like 88 or 87 or above. I could be wrong on that. Let's make the strength better, I guess. So I do more damage just regularly. I feel like I can, at least if I'm getting beat up, I can run out of the ring. So I don't know if I necessarily need to do endurance. So here we go. No match on Raw next week. That is annoying. Skip that. Need to get into a storyline. Maybe I'll defend the title at Backlash. We'll see. Alright, let's see if I have a match. Nope, skip, skip, and skip. Undertaker is the new WWE champion now. Oh, here we go. Hang on there, Jeff. I want to offer you a shot at the tag team title. How do you feel about that? Sure. I knew that you would like that offer. Now let's talk about a tag partner. I'd like to want you to team up with RVD. Okay. I know you guys don't get along, but think about it. The fans won't see this coming at all. They'll go nuts. If you don't like this setup, then I can't offer you the tag team challenge shot. What's your decision? Challenge anyway. That's kind of crazy, because I'm pretty sure RVD is a hardcore champ. So if RVD is a hardcore champ, I'm the Intercontinental champ, then we're going to have the tag team championships? That's like... pretty crazy, actually, if we pull that off. I think that's going to do it for the first episode, guys. Make sure you hit the like button and subscribe if you're new here to Tap Plays Games. I'm Tyler. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll talk to you in the next episode.